Hey guys, today we're going to talk about e-scouting or cyber scouting for white-tailed deer. This will be episode one in the series. In this episode, we're going to go over setting up your map options in Caltopo.com. E-scouting has been responsible for a lot of the deer that you're seeing in this collage right now. Okay guys, let's get into it. First tip, step number one, I like to start on the computer, not on my cell phone. I find it difficult to identify the small areas of interest on a smartphone screen, so I complete the overwhelming majority of my cyber scouting on a computer. Right now, I'm using a Lenovo Y520. That model is discontinued, but you could use something like a Lenovo Y540. That's a newer version of the same computer. There's a link in the description. I like this particular laptop because it's a gaming laptop. That means it has a better video card and more RAM, and this computer also doubles as my video editing computer. So when I start any cyber scouting, I like to open up my favorite two websites, one of which is free, and the first one is caltopo.com. So I'm going to go ahead and pull that up right now. Now, if you've never used Caltopo before, this is going to be the main screen. Just go ahead and click accept use and the start mapping icon here. Once you're on the main screen here, go ahead and type in the search box your area of interest. As you can see here, you can type in a city and a state or GPS coordinates. Right now, I'm just going to go ahead and type in a state. Since we're talking about deer hunting, let's talk about everyone's favorite state, and I'm going to look at Iowa. My main goal during this initial phase of cyber scouting is to identify properties with as many key terrain and/or vegetation features as possible before committing to boots on the ground scouting and investing significant time and expense to thoroughly scout an area by foot. Now, not all areas are created equal. I purposely avoid homogeneous terrain. Let me repeat that. I purposely avoid homogeneous terrain. While homogeneous terrain may hold deer, by comparison to heterogeneous terrain, it makes identifying key terrain and vegetation features and high percentage stand locations much more difficult via online resources. So for that reason, I'm going to skip over any homogeneous terrain. So here is an aerial photograph of homogeneous terrain. As you can see, this property is essentially flat with no elevation change, and it contains very little vegetation diversity. So this is the type of property I'm going to want to avoid. Now here is an aerial photograph with a topo overlay of heterogeneous terrain, which contains considerable diversity in both terrain and vegetation. These are the types of properties that I'm looking to key in during my cyber scouting. Now back to Caltopo. The best tool for scouting terrain is the topographical or topo map. When topo scouting for whitetails on Caltopo, I use the following map options. First, from the main base layer, which is right here, I like to select the scanned 7.5 topographical map. As you can see, this adds more detail than the standard base map. Once I've switched my base layer to the scan 7.5 map, the next step is to go back under the map options. And here I want to enable the contours. So I'm going to click the contours box. And the default is mixed. Because I want as much fidelity in my topo map as possible, I'm going to click the drop-down menu here and select the 10-foot option. Once I've selected that, you can see there's even more fidelity in the topo lines now, and that's what I'm looking for. And finally, while I'm still under this map overlays option, I want to go ahead and click the box for slope angle shading. What slope angle shading does is it gives a color reference to the steepness of a slope, and that's indicated by these colors and degrees here. And there's also a drop-down box here, and it's default to fixed, but I prefer the gradient option, so I'm going to go ahead and select gradient. And now if I zoom in, you can see here these red lines indicate steeper slopes. So anywhere you see a color, it's going to be a steeper slope compared to an area with no color. Now I'm going to go ahead and zoom out. Now I want to find an area that has a lot of topographical diversity. Okay, now I'm looking at an area with more topographical diversity. The next step I want to do on my map setup is add a vegetation layer. To do that, I'm going to go back here to the main menu option. And right here below base layers, there's the option to stack an additional layer. Go ahead and click that. And then in this blank drop-down box, if you select there, there's this aerial imagery. There's a couple different options. I usually like to select the NAIP 2013 through 2015 or similar. Sometimes the options here aren't all the same. But click the newest one. So I'm going to go ahead and add that. And now you can see it didn't really do anything. because I have to adjust this control right here. Under your added layer, there's an opacity control that's going to control how visible that underlying layer is. So I'm going to go ahead and bump this up to 50. And once I do that, you can see that the underlying aerial photograph is there as well now with the topographic line overlaid on top of that. Now this is important to me because I want to have a good mix of what the topography is like and what the vegetation is like. It's important for me to add the vegetation layer. For example, if I'm looking for saddles and I find a saddle in the middle of an open field, that's not as valuable to me as a saddle in the middle of a woodlot. So those are steps one and two for me. First, I want to get on my computer, not my phone, to CyberScout. Second, I want to get on Caltopo.com and I want to set up my maps as I just described. These map setup options are going to allow me to see both the terrain features and the vegetation in the area. That concludes episode one of the series. If you enjoyed the content, please like and subscribe. Stay tuned for episode two, where I'm going to go over different resources to help identify the primary wind direction in a new hunting area.